Hello, we are AGH Space Systems from AGH University of Krakow, Poland. We would like to present our preparations for this year's University Rover Challenge 2024. Kalman is our rover, which is still evolving, allowing for iterative development and replacing entire subsystems without suspending the rover's operability. Our team consists of students from various academic backgrounds, from robotics and computer science to chemistry and geology.
The rover's drive system is based on a rocker suspension and four independently turned and propelled wheels. This allows us to drive sideways, diagonally, and turn in place. The tires were 3D printed and are the result of many tests and iterative experiments. The mechanical design significantly increases effective ground clearance and helps to maintain rover stability on extremely uneven surfaces. The rover manipulator is the result of several years of development. It boasts 6 degrees of freedom, brushless DC motors, and a decentralized controller. The manipulator has a spacious working area that allows for sampling, lifting objects to great heights, and performing maintenance tasks. The flexibility of the design means that we can easily swap end effector gloves for different missions or attach tech-specific modules and cameras.
Good serviceability is one of our main design goals. Batteries quickly slide in and out of 3D printed mountings outside the frame. The arm is connected with just 4 screws and 2 cables. All essential PCBs for our rover and its modules are designed with uniform physical dimensions. They slide right into a single 3D printed box. All of this allows us to switch the rover's configuration between maintenance and autonomous missions in under 10 minutes, while staying under the 50 kilos weight limit. The rover has been fitted with an easily accessible red emergency button which physically breaks the connection to the batteries, completely shutting the power off. Communication between the rover and the ground station is ensured by 4 33 MHz full duplex RF modules, and video feedback is provided by a 5.8 GHz link. This has been tested to provide comfortable control over the rover on distances reaching 1 km with minimum video delay. We also develop an additional camera module in the gripper which provides high resolution video source.
Recently, we refactored our autonomous navigation system to use ROS2 with the latest versions of packages. The odometry subsystem is based around the unstinted common filter with inputs from 4 IR-based depth cameras, IMU and GPS, which ensures up to 5 cm accuracy. We use the IR cameras to map the terrain and to generate a slope-sensitive cost map. Fast and robust computer vision algorithms are used to detect and localize rock attacks. We also use our own package, which integrates YOLO object detection with the ROS2 ecosystem. This package allows us to easily train YOLO models for any computer vision tasks in future competitions. This time, of course, it was trained to see mallets and water bottles.
In addition, we developed a custom Unity engine-based simulation, where we can achieve high visual fidelity required to run visual odometry, and leverage C# scripting capabilities to quickly and easily implement interactive testing environments. Over the past year, we have been collecting feedback from operators and refactoring our ground station. We control the rover with an intuitive, custom-made controller that can take advantage of our rover's driving model. The manipulator is controlled with a space mouse supporting inverse kinematics or a standard gamepad. We also have the ability to record and execute predefined trajectories.
The rover's payload for the science mission is composed of several modules. The life occurrence in soil samples is detected using a mobile laboratory, which contains a soil extracting ultrasonic chamber, spectrophotometer with specific biomarker tests, and fluorescence analyzer. The captured spectral data provides 4 factors of the life presence based on the DNA, amino acids, carbohydrates, and chlorophyll content. The geological site context analysis will be performed through a high-resolution camera system. The scale on the wide angle panorama will be provided by a time-of-flight sensor. As geological support for the delivery task, the visible near-infrared reflectance probe with fluorescence mode shall also be included. According to the prepared spectral database, the analytical instrument can determine and identify types of minerals.
We are working on a 3D model, taking and seeing subsurface samples. We manufactured the prototype where we identified the subsystem problems. We consulted our issues with the expert and created a design of the next iteration that eliminates errors, has smaller dimensions, and sufficiently reduced weight. In addition, we will place a small probe on the manipulator, which will allow us to measure soil moisture at the appropriate depth.
In addition, each year we take part in numerous science fairs to inspire future generations. None of this would be possible without support from our university, Ministry of Education and Science, and our private sponsors. Thank you and see you in space!